ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह, ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह,
मुहम्मदुन रसूलुल्लाह, मुहम्मदुन रसूलुल्लाह।
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह वकफा والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى اما بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن اياته ان خلق لكم من انفسكم ازواجا لتسكنوا اليها وجعل بينكم موده ورحمه إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يتفكرون سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم الإسلام is a نعمت of Allah سبحانه وتعالى Our Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he showed us the right path, how to have a successful life in this world and in the hereafter. Life of a person has different phases. In the beginning, a person is a child. Then he grows up and becomes an adult young man. Then he gets married. Then another phase comes and becomes a father. So to be a father is another phase. He has different responsibilities. He has rights of different persons upon him. Because he is living in the society, he has to interact with other ones. Subhanallah, this is the beauty of Islam, that everything has been spelled out, clearly told, what one has to do at what time. If a person is adult and still waiting for his nikah, then we have been told by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that in this situation, the young man should keep fasting. So that he should have patience. He should be able to control himself. The best way of having a good life is that when a person comes to that situation, when he can afford nikah, he should make it. This nikah helps him to have a life of taqwa. فَانْكِحُوا مَا طَابَ لَكُم مِّنَ النِّسَاءِ مَثْنَى وَثُلَاثَ وَرُبَاعَ فَإِن لَّمْ تَعْدِلُوا فَوَاحِدَةً. You should make nikah with the women whom you like. And if you cannot make justice in between them, then you should have only one. The prophets of Allah Ta'ala who came in this world, they had a married life. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ أَزْوَاجًا وَذُرِّيَّةً. It's in Quran. That we made wives and they had their children. So Islam does not tell us to go in the forest, to sit in a cave, and in this way you can become very close to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. No. We have to stay in the society, fulfill our responsibilities, And in this way, we will be able to get the proximity and closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالرَّحْمَانِيَةَ مِنْ بَرَعِهَا مَا كَبَدْنَاهَا عَلَيْهِ. The Christians, they invented one amal, which was rahbaniyat. They thought that this married life is a hindrance in the way and path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one should stay alone and then worship. They used to say that the male should stay like the life of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, and the woman should stay with the life of Sayyida Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam. But this was not the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was their own thought. Islam told us that wife is not a hindrance and hurdle in getting the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's rather an assistance to a person. It has been told in one of the ahadith that people choose their wives due to four things. Number one, due to the wealth of the woman. If she is from very rich family, then people, they want to make nikah. Second, due to the family, caste. Then third, due to the personality and beauty of the woman. And fourth, due to the virtuous personality, because she is very pious. So pious personality. So Rasulullah ﷺ told us that you should choose your wife due to the pious personality. Because then she will take care of your children and will help you to go on the path of Sharia throughout your life. Normally what people do a mistake that they choose their wife just due to the facial beauty. And facial beauty is always skin deep, very little depth. So within next few days, then they feel one wants to go according to the sunnah path. But the wife, she says, no, I have my own choices. And then starts difference of opinion. One thing is decided. When nikah will be cheap, zina will become costly. And when nikah will become costly, zina will become cheap. So that's why we should promote nikah, because this is halal. This is worship. We have been told by Rasulullah ﷺ that a married person, after making nikah, when he makes his salat, he gets the reward of 42 namaz, 42 prayers. Why? Because when he was alone, he had no responsibility of wife. Now he has made nikah. He has got the responsibility. Now he has got two responsibilities. One, the rights of the wife, and one, the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is fulfilling the right of the wife and right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, because he is fulfilling two duties, I am going to give him double reward. Islam has told us that after marriage, the couple should live with each other with great love. The more they will love each other, they will get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if the husband spends his money on wife and children, he gets the reward of making the best sadaqa in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. and in one of the hadith, that if the husband, he looks towards the wife and smiles, and the wife, she looks towards the husband and smiles, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at both of them and then he smiles. So nikah is an act of worship, is a decent way of living in this world. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made things easy for us. But for married life, the situation of husband and wife is just like two good friends. Wife is not like a slave, just like two friends who have made a firm agreement to share the sorrows and pleasures of the life. So their bodies are two, but their soul has become one. Their hearts have been joined together. There is one famous sentence in English, that house is built by hands, but the home is built by hearts. You join the bricks and the house is ready, but when the heart will join, then the home will be ready. So for husband and wife, the heart joined together. In Islam, the marriage is not the joining of two persons together. No. It's joining of two families together. By nikah, not only two persons are joining together, two families are joining together. Because after nikah, then the parents of the husband become the parents for the wife. And the parents of the wife become parents for the husband. So before marriage, he has got one father and one mother. But after marriage, everyone has two fathers and two mothers. The mother-in-law and father-in-law, they have the status like a father and mother for the husband. So if we give them respect like father and mother, there will be no disputes at all. The problems come when the mother of the husband, she differentiates, this is my daughter and this is my daughter-in-law. If you look at both of them, that these two of them are my daughters, and give them the love of mother, no problems. And the girl, she feels, this is my mother, but this is my mother-in-law. No, she has got the right just like mother. So if she will stop differentiating in between them, she will feel both of them are my mothers. No disputes. The disputes are due to ourselves. Islam has showed us the path and given us the guidance how to have a very good life. So after marriage, wife has got the rights on husband and the husband has got the rights on wife. Each one of them should try to fulfill their own rights. Now what happens? That the wife always remembers what rights she has upon the husband. And the husband only remembers what he has rights on the wife. Ask the husband, they know the hadith. Oh, Rasulullah SAW told us that if it was permissible, I would have ordered the wife to make sajda to the husband. Every husband will know this hadith. But he will not know what are the rights of the wife. So the problem is that we don't fulfill what we are supposed to do, and then become the problem. وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. And the wife has the rights on the husband as the husband has rights on the wife. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given preference to the husband because anyhow one has to be made the in charge of the house, of the family. If you run a small shop, you make one person responsible. If you have a very small business, you make one person responsible. Similarly, Allah Ta'ala has made the husband responsible for the family. So he has got the preference. But both of them, they are the servants of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. As a human being, she has got this right on husband, and husband has got the rights on wife. So everyone should try to fulfill the right of the other. Now what happens? That the husband thinks, my wife should be loyal to me, should be loving to me, should serve me, should prepare everything, clean the house, and then she should prepare food at time and take care of my dress and everything. But me? No problem if I come late at night. If I spend my time with the friends, if I don't take care of him, if he talks, I listen from this ear and then go out from this. So when he has this much attitude, it will create problems. And similarly, the wife feels that the husband should be so nice to me that if even I just speak a little bit, he should understand what I want and he should fulfill the requirement. But to me, it's not necessary that he comes late at night and I should prepare hot food for him. I should smile because he has come in the house. I want to keep sleeping. He should come, go to the kitchen, prepare his food, sleep. When this is the situation, then the problems arise. And then it's our fault. That we want, others should fulfill our needs, our rights, but we should not. Similarly, wife feels that the husband should fulfill my needs, but I should not. This is bad. This is injustice. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوَّزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ We will be mutaffif. If we want that the husband should become a good husband, but the wife, she is not going to become a good wife. Each one of them can be mutaffif. Mutaffif is not only sitting on the shop or business. No. In our daily life, if we don't take care of justice, we are also one of the mutaffifin. And there is very far the mutaffifin. So in married life, husband should try to fulfill the rights of the wife and the wife should try to fulfill the rights of the husband. They will have a happy life. It's very easy to have a good life, but the person, he should take care of the rights of the other. One good principle is that after marriage, the wife, she should make the relatives of the husband happy. Keep good relationship with them. And the husband, he should keep good relationship with the relatives of the wife. Both of them should be like that. Husband should always think that I should keep the relatives of my wife happy. We should have good relations with them. It should be the duty of the husband. Similarly, it should be the duty of the wife to keep good relationship with the relatives of the husband. No problem. Now what happens? That the boy wants to keep good relationship with his family, but to the girl he makes some restrictions. And similarly, wife, she wants to have a good relationship with his family, but puts restrictions for him, for his parents. That becomes problem. So problems is due to us. We malfunction, that's why problems are created. If we go according to Sharia and Sunnah, subhanallah, we can have a very beautiful and successful life, happy life. Husband and wife, they should think that now we are life partner to each other. Our pleasures are one and our sorrows are one. So that's why we should try to have one thought, one thinking. Our thinking should be same. Our way of living should be same. We should try to adjust with each other. And then the life will be very easy. One person came to me and said, "Hazrat, I'm tired of my wife. I want to divorce her." "Why? We are always quarreling with each other. When there are disputes, then both of them quarrel with each other. And those persons who are not living according to the Sharia don't ask us about their lives. Oh, they are having difficult life. They say life is very difficult. It's famous that someone told that in the beginning, after the marriage, I used to speak and my wife used to listen. Then there were children. No, the wife used to speak and the husband used to listen. And then in the old age, the children got married and both of them were the old. They used to say, we both used to speak and the other person used to listen. Whenever we will deviate from the way of Sunnah, we will create problem for us. So it's very easy to lead our life according to the Sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The life will become very easy. There will be love in between the hearts of the couple. That's why in Islam there is love after marriage. In kuffar, there is love marriage. But in Islam, there is love after marriage. When you got married, no. Live with as much love as you can. You will get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that person came to me and said that I want to divorce my wife. I said, why? He has, I have lot of problems in my life. I said, okay. I feel you are missing something. That's why there are problems. I have the remedy. He said, "Hazrat, tell me. What is the remedy?" He seemed to be very disappointed. I told him, "Make promise. Whatever I will tell you, you will do it." He said, "Yes." So he made promise. I asked him, "Just tell me, when you come from your business to your home, do you enter in your house according to Sunnah?" He said, "No, I don't know." I told him that when you enter, do you read the dua what Prophet ﷺ has told us? He said, "I don't know." I said, "If you don't read, Shaitan enters with you in your house. He gets the permission to enter in. But if you will read the dua, what Rasulullah told us to enter in the house, Shaitan will stay back. He will not be allowed to go in." This is number one. Then I said, "When you come inside the house, do you say Assalamu alaikum to your family?" He said, "No." I said, another point. And the third and biggest point, Sayyid Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha, she narrated that Rasulullah, whenever he used to enter his house, he used to enter with a cheerful face, smiling face. So I said, "You come with the smiling face in your house?" He said, "No, never." I said, "That's the basic problem. Now you have made promise with me that you will enter your house with your smiling face. And he acted upon this sunnah, and both of them had a successful life. Just missing one sunnah, they had problems in their life. So it's the Prophet, it's the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When you come to your family, come with a smiling face. If you have worried about the business, keep them aside. So sunnah way is the best way to live in this world. Once I was reading a book, there was written analysis of the demons of the world. They said that different women of different countries have different habits. For example, in Japan, it's a custom that whenever the husband has to go to the office, then the wife, she will bring the shoes, put in front of them, or help him to wear the shoes. The wife, she feels a pride. This is a custom for the Japanese. She will not do cooking, not do anything in the house, but one work she will do with pride. And what's that? That when husband wants to go, she will bring the shoes, put in front of him, and help him to wear it. So this is a special point about a Japanese wife. Then, after the analysis, they wrote that in the world, German wife is the most loyal wife for the husband. And they quoted one example. They said that once there was a German couple and they were having a good life. One day, the wife, she was sorting out her clothes, new clothes on one side for the laundry, and the old clothes, worn out clothes on one side, she wanted to make it trash. But the husband had some job. He came running and told his wife that if you do that thing, I will be very thankful to you because I am in a hurry. She said, I am doing this. He said, I can do this on your behalf, but you do that. She said, okay. So she left the job. She went there. Now the husband, he started out the clothes, and then he made a mistake that the clothes which he had to put in the trash, he put it in the laundry. Husbands are like that. And the clothes, new clothes, which he had to put in the laundry, he put it into the trash can, and they went. Now when the next day, the wife, she got up, and she had to prepare to go to the office, and she went in the laundry room to get the clothes from the drying machine, dryer. She thought everything which was just spare to come in the house. The same day, his son died just before, few hours before his arrival. Now the mother, she had dead body of the son. But at the same time she thought, my husband will come, and when he will listen that I had a baby son, but now he has died, his heart will be broken. So what she did, she just gave bath to the son, and then put it on some place, and covered it with a sheet of cloth. And then she changed the dress and get prepared for the husband. When he came, she was in a very good mood. The husband asked him, what happened? She said, I had a son. Where is he? She said, he is in rest. She said, he is in rest. Because it was night time. The husband thought that the child is sleeping. He said, okay, I can see him in the morning. And then he took food, and the husband and wife, they had good time with each other. In the morning, the wife talked to the husband. that if someone lends you something, amanat, and after some time he wants it back, should we give with open-hearted or not? He said, no, if it is amanat, then we should give it with pleasure, because it is amanat. He said, then listen please, that we have been given the amanat of his son by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and now he has taken it back. Please give this amanat with the open heart. And the husband, he was amazed. Oh, my son has died? She said, yes. He said, okay, it is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am happy. But then he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my wife is such a good lady. She was mother, and her son's dead body was lying on the bed. How she was so cheerful to me, good to me, so nice to me, just for my pleasure, she took care of me. Then Rasulullah he gave him dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give barakat in their night. Give barakat in their night. Subhanallah, due to that night, his wife became pregnant again. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them another son, which became Hafiz-e-Quran and Hafiz-e-Hadith. So look at the Muslim wife. If she knows what is Islam, then she will take care of the pleasure of the husband. She will take care of the comfort for the husband. She will know what are the vices of the husband. Subhanallah. So the best way to lead a life is according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let me tell you two stories about my Akabirin. Because from the stories of the Akabirin, we get the lesson how we should live in this world. One is about Hazrat Maulana Qasim Nanauti rahmatullah alayhi. And this story was narrated by Qari Muhammad Tayyib rahmatullah alayhi to my Shaykh, and my Shaykh narrated this story to me. Subhanallah. Qari Muhammad Tayyib rahmatullah alayhi narrated that my grandmother, the wife of Hazrat Maulana Qasim Nanauti rahmatullah alayhi, she was the daughter of a very rich man, Nawab. And that rich man, he wanted that his daughter should become the wife of Maulana Qasim Nanauti rahmatullah alayhi, because he loved Maulana Nanauti rahmatullah alayhi. Then after the nikah, the bride came to the home. Then she had lot of golden ornaments, because she was the daughter of a rich man. Then she said that first night when Maulana Qasim Nanauti rahmatullah alayhi, he came to me. First he said, Assalamu alaikum. I answered. Then he sat on my side on the bed and told me that the purpose of nikah and marriage is to have a good life and to save each other from the sins. It is the duty of the husband to save the wife from the sins, to protect her from the sins, and it is the duty of the wife to protect the husband from the sins. So we have to protect each other from the sins. This is the basic spirit of making nikah. We should assist each other in being protected from the sins. And then he said that we can have a good life if our status is same. But no, I am a poor person and you are a rich lady, so there is a hell of difference in between our status. So then she said, oh, it can't be same. Hazrat Nanauti rahmatullah alayhi, he said, it can be same very easily. Oh, that if I want to be rich like you, it will take whole of my life. Maybe I cannot be like that. But if you want to be like me, it's very easy. She said, then what? He said, you know, there is jihad of Turkey at that time. Turk Muslim, they were having jihad. So it's better that you give all of your gold and other things to Mujahideen. So you and me will be on the same status, we will have a good life. She said that I took all my ornaments and everything and give it to Hazrat, and Hazrat sent it for Mujahideen. But after the marriage, next few days, women come to see the bride. So one of the old lady, sometimes these old ladies are, subhanallah, special blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hazrat Ali rahmatullah alayh, he was always very soft with the old ladies. He wrote in his book that because they have their special thinking, he quoted that one old lady came to me and then said, I want just to ask that it is the same God who is alive up till now, who was at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Their thinking are like that. One lady came and she said, that I have this problem, this problem, this problem. And then she said, oh, I don't want to tell you because then Allah will say she is making my complaint. So that old lady, she came to the house of Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah alayh to see the bride. When she looked at her, she had good personality, clean clothes, everything, but no ornaments. Then she made comments, oh, I think her parents hated her. She was the burden of the parents. They just pushed them out from their house without any gold, without any ornaments. Now when she listened, she started crying. The old lady went, left her crying. Then Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah, when he came back to his home, he found his wife crying, asked, what happened to you? She said, I just want to go at my home. Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah asked him anything else. She said, no, just want to go at my home. Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah took him and then left him at her home. At that time, the women used to live in one part of the house, but the male used to live in the other part of the house. The house was made like that. The father, he never knew that my daughter has come back. After 3 days, he just came on the women's side and he saw the daughter. And then he asked, are you okay? She said, yes. But he was very astonished. He asked the wife, why your daughter came back? She told him, this happened. He said, this is not a big problem. He again made the same ornaments, gave it to her and took her and brought her to the house of Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah. Now the grandmother, she narrates that when Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah came to me this night, then he said, after assalamu alaikum, that, oh my wife, I never forced you to give your ornaments in the path of Allah. You did it yourself. It was your choice. If you never wanted to do that, you should have said me no. Because now I am ashamed in front of my father-in-law. I just tell you what you will do this with these things. These are just like snakes and other insects. So the grandmother, she narrated that it was the tawajjuh of Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah alayh, that when he said that these are just like snake and other things, I felt as if the ornaments are like that, the snake in my neck. So that I wanted to snake everything. And Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah alayh was saying, no, don't do that, don't. I said, no, I don't need it. So she again took all the jewelry and gold and gave it to Hazrat Nanati. Please give it again in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will never make any complaint. And alhamdulillah, the next day, she asked Hazrat Nanati rahmatullah alayh that I want to learn the ilm from you. Hazrat Nanaji Rahmatullah Alayh, then he started giving him lessons and she learned so much from Hazrat Nanaji Rahmatullah Alayh that Hazrat Qari Muhammad Tayyib Rahmatullah Alayh said that I learned Mishkat Sharif from my grandmother lesson by lesson in my life. Subhanallah. This was the life of our ancestors, of our Qadirin. That Hazrat Nanaji Rahmatullah taught him so much that she became a teacher of Mishkat Sharif. Subhanallah. Hazrat Maulana Ahmad Lahori Rahmatullah Alayh, once he narrated his own marriage story to my Shaykh, and my Shaykh told me, he said that because he was from a Sikh family, he accepted Islam, that's why he was phased out. The family member, they phased him out. Go away, no relationship. You became Muslim. So what he did? He came to Darul Uloom Deoband. He narrated a story. He said that my father-in-law, when he was told by the wife that our daughter has become adult, we should take care of her nikah, but towards her bed, he said, okay, let me select a good husband for my daughter. And then he started a journey of the madaris to search for a good husband of his daughter. And from different madaris, he went to Darul Uloom Deoband. Hazrat Shaykh al-Hind Rahmatullah Alayh, he was Shaykh al-Hadith at that time. And Hazrat Lahori Rahmatullah Alayh, Maulana Ahmad al-Lahori Rahmatullah Alayh, he was a student. So when his father-in-law, he himself was an alim, then he looked at the students. He just had a glance on the face of Maulana Ahmad al-Lahori Rahmatullah Alayh. Now he was having a very tough life because he was poor, hand to mouth. No family, no one to support him. So he was in very tight conditions at that time. But his father-in-law, he had a great vision. اتقوا فراسة المؤمن فإنه ينظر بنور الله. So he looked at the face of Maulana Ahmad al-Lahori Rahmatullah Alayh. And then he asked Hazrat Shaykh al-Hind Rahmatullah Alayh, is this young man married? He said, no. He is one of the Sikh family. And he accepted Islam. Now he is becoming alim. He said, ask him. If he wants to marry, then I am prepared to offer my daughter for nikah. Hazrat Shaykh al-Hind Rahmatullah asked him, you want to get married? Hazrat Maulana Lahori Rahmatullah, he replied that this is Sunnah and because I have no relatives, so I have no chance that anyone will be prepared to marry his daughter with me. So if someone is prepared, this is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then my father-in-law, he said, okay, tomorrow after asr prayer there will be nikah ceremony. Tomorrow after asr prayer there will be nikah ceremony because you have got permission from the daughter and everything. Then what happened? Hazrat Lahori Rahmatullah Alayh, he came back to his room and he told his fellow students that tomorrow after asr my nikah will take place. Now the students are students. Yes? Man of the day is smiling. So then they started discussing with each other. And one of them, he suggested, oh, you have old clothes. But tomorrow, in the ceremony, at the time of ceremony, you should be dressed up with new clothes. Hazrat Lahori told him, no, I have only this dress, only one dress, and I will wear the same. He said, borrow it from someone. He said, no, it's against my personality. I don't want to borrow the dress from anyone. Then the students, they read mantik. Yes. Isa Goji, Kaha Atul, Mirkat, Shara Tati. Then he came up with the idea. He said, oh, if you don't want to marry, if you don't want to borrow this dress from someone, okay, tomorrow in the morning, you should take this dress and put some chadar, wear yourself, and then wash it, clean it, so that it will become clean. At the time of ceremony, you should come with the clean dress. He said, yes, this is workable, feasible, I can do that. And then he narrated that I was unfortunate to accept his opinion. Why? Because then in the day, I took off my dress and wore some chadar and washed it. Then it was winter and they were cloudy. So I washed the clothes, but they were not drying up. 2-3 hours, after 2-3 hours, they were still wet. Now the time of Asr is coming closer and closer. And I took my clothes on the other side of the mark and I was shaking it like this. And making dua, oh Allah, make my dress dry. Make my dress dry. And it never dried up at that time. And until there was a time of Azan, so when Azan was made, I was forced to wear the same wet dress on my body. Wet dress in the season of winter. And he said that my father-in-law had a heart made of gold. He looked at me at the time of ceremony. Yesterday, I was having the same dress which was dirty. Today, I am having the same dress which is wet. It means no other dress. The person with the wet dress at the time of ceremony. But he never took care of these things. These are small things, having no significance. He was looking at my heart, at my personality, at my taqwa. Subhanallah, at my taqwa. So he made nikah. And I got married. I completed the hadith and brought my wife at my home. When I brought my wife at my home, in the earlier days, I had nothing to spend. So sometime I had something to eat and sometime I had nothing to eat. When I had nothing to eat, my wife used to suggest, can you bring some leaves of trees? We both will eat. Can you bring some leaves of tree? We both will eat. And I used to bring leaves from the tree. Me and my wife used to take the leaves, drink the water, and used to sleep. In the earlier time of marriage, just within few days, this was my situation. And the wife, she was living with me in such a tight circumstances, and she spent 1 month with me. After 1 month, then his father came and took her to his home for the first time. But my wife, she was so pious, so loyal, so good, that when she went back, her mother asked her, oh my daughter, how you find your new house? And she replied that, oh mom, I used to think that when I will die, I will go to paradise. But now I feel that I am alive and I have reached in the paradise. Subhanallah, subhanallah. This is the life of a Muslim husband and Muslim wife. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to follow the sunnah of our Prophet ﷺ and to have a successful life. We have got together today for the nikah of one of our brother. So we will make dua inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give barakat, give rahmat in his life, and he should have a pleasureful, successful life. And wife and husband both should coordinate with each other, assist each other in spending the lifetime according to the teachings of the Prophet ﷺ. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
रब करीम जिस बच्चे और बच्चों को निकाह हुआ अल्लाह